comfort that Alison has around my leg. It's like, there's no fear. I personally think that that creates a really nice connection between patient and prosthetist. A connection that I don't have with anyone else because no one else ever really sees or touches my stump. But I also think that what she creates is pretty beautiful. So there's so much beauty here that no one's seeing. They're like surrounded by it, but they don't see it.
Right, do you want to take that leg off then?
Very small skin at the moment. It's quite bad, actually.
So it is.
And like around here.
Those bits look like eczema, don't they?
Yeah.
Like,
I've tried kind of everything on it, it just doesn't really help.
And that, I think, is because we have the tendency to be a bit valgus.
Yeah.
And that socket digs in more there, which of course we could heat out, but you'll have a bit more of a gap there. But yeah, I think that's what causes that pressure. This bit doesn't look too bad. I'm going to need your liner back on again to cast, actually. Let's try and keep that clean. Just marking all your bony bits.
Theory, this should just peel off.
Look at that.
This neck gets great.
The 10 of us that work here all still take casts by hand. I think I take a really nice, smooth cast. That does not correlate into a lovely fitting socket, may I just add? If I think I've taken a nice cast and I've smoothed it in and I've worked it in, then to me, I must surely be a bit closer to getting a nicer fitting socket.
when you think about prosthetics, you don't think about the people that make them, or really even the people that wear them. Like, you kind of just think about them as objects, and I think that they're so connected to people in so many ways that it's really funny that we forget that.
I don't know if people just think they're taken off the shelf. I mean, they are made individually for everyone. However, just because it's cast on you, then made, doesn't always, as you know, say that it's going to fit. And there are, unfortunately, some people that you just can never get comfortable. I probably, if I'm honest, don't see them as an extension of someone's body, because I never do. I guess I just don't think that way.
See, I really do.
Do you?
Yeah. Like, if, obviously I don't mind you holding it, but if anyone else picks up my prosthesis, I'd get really.
Oh, do you really?
Yeah. I could feel myself, like, just feeling a bit kind of panicky. I mean, that feels pretty good.
It looks better there, yeah. But it looks as if that might just need a wee flare on that edge there.
Yeah.
Because I think that will dig in. But it looks a bit better.
If I sit down, could we flare out both back parts? Just because when I sit, I think that will really irritate me.
So a wee bit there, And just that corner there, I think.
Yeah, but I don't...
Although when you're standing, I want to just flare that one as well.
I think only flat. I quite like how high it is.
Yeah, so don't trim.
Just
heat out.
Yeah.
Okie doke.
And it doesn't even need too much out.
Maybe not there, but it does. I see what you mean there. It does need that corner to come out.
Yeah, actually. When just I put right weight on it, you can see it's really digging in. Mm-hmm.
Right,
well, feels very that. Comfy, though, otherwise.
Does it?
Yeah.
Oh, wait till you start walking. Now, just curiously, as you're sitting, can you turn and sit face the mirror? I just want to see where your toe is when you're sitting.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
So now try walking in that. So do you feel when you hit the ground, your foot's hitting the ground flat, or do you think you're on one side or the other? But you do have a whip, there's no doubt about it.
Yeah, I do. I don't think I've got a whip in my other leg.
Just think when you're standing, your heels off the ground a little. Move your feet a few steps and then stand back again. Adding a little bit of Loctite. Mm-hmm. And then torquing it. I guess there is an acceptance, isn't there? That you have to accept that, yes, you're an amputee, and it does attract attention. People do look, don't they?
Definitely don't want a leg that looks like fake leg, because I don't see the point in pretending that my prosthetic is anything but it is. But also, like, I want to be able to be, like, comfortable and proud. But other people's views do get in the way of that, and it does make it really, really hard. And so I'm always aware there's this idea of what a body should look like, and so we're going to cover up something or pretend it's something else.
Thank you.